Hello, welcome back to my channel, and today I am going to talk about how do you register as a graduate engineer in BEM in Malaysia. So usually as a student right after you graduate in the university from any engineering degree, be it mechanical, be it electrical, or be it mechatronics. So I'm going to walk you through on how do we do the registration in BEM, what to take note and what materials do you need, and the general process flow of the registration. And not only that, I will also share my experiences of my hiccups during registering as a graduate engineer. So first up, before your registration on the website, I think it's definitely recommended to have your documents ready prior to starting the registration, because I think the momentum would be break if you did not have your documents ready and you went straight to it, and then you would have hiccups here and there, which slows down your registration process by a lot. So the first step is to get ready all your documents that are needed for the registration. First is your IC, identity card. If you are not a Malaysian and you are a foreign student, you could use your passport. Prepare your photocopy of your passport or IC. Secondly is to prepare your university transcript. If you have a diploma, get your diploma transcript as well, because you can also key in that detail on the website later. So besides your university or diploma transcript, also remember to prepare your university certificate that says that you have graduated from this course from your university. After you prepare your IC and your transcript as well as your university certificate, get these three documents get these three documents to be stamped by an IR. So I would recommend you to get it stamped in your university where you have professors who are registered as a professional engineer already. They need to certify that. And apart from that, after getting your documents certified, also prepare your passport size photograph. Okay, good job. Now that you have got all your documents ready, now let's walk through the workflow of applying as a graduate engineer. So first of all, go to www.engineers.org.my, which is the portal for registration as a graduate engineer, as a professional engineer, or as a certified practicing professional engineer, and that's the website to go to. Okay, after you go to the website, the first thing you need to do is to register an account, which is your username and password, and then it will direct you into the registration portal. So as soon as you went in, you can start filling up a form, which looks like this. Okay, and then next is to upload your documents based on the items that is listed there. So you upload your IC, you upload your transcript, your university certificate, as well as your photograph, which is a passport size photograph. So after you have uploaded the document that has been stamped by IR, the next step of the flow is to pay a 50 ringgit application fee. That 50 ringgit that you are paying for the application is non-refundable, bear in mind. However, if your application got rejected or your document is incomplete, do not worry, because the 50 ringgit would still be there. You just need to resubmit the relevant documents that are asked for and as instructed by them. So after your submission for approval, you would have to wait maybe several weeks for them to vet through your profile and along with other candidates that applied. So be patient and check your email every week or so. And if you receive an email from BEM, they would tell you the application of your status, whether is it approved or is it rejected. Say your application is rejected, do not worry, because they would tell you what are the documents they required from you, what additional documents, or whether if your profile, your documents are not stamped, or whether your photographs are not clear or doesn't fit the requirement, they would state it there. So the next thing you are going to do is to reply to that email with the documents that are required. You would have to reply to the email as soon as possible because the email only has a validity of 2 weeks. They have given you 2 weeks to reply to them with the documents necessary for the application. Do not wait too long to reply because your application will need to be resubmitted, say after the 2 weeks. However, your payment of 50 ringgit would still be valid and you don't have to repay. But however, you would need to wait longer for the reapplication. And that's it for the application, and congratulations that you have made it through the application and managed to get it approved. I would highly encourage everyone to apply as soon as you graduate, because if you wanted to pursue the road to become a professional engineer, you would require at least 2 years of experience. So for example, if you have worked from May 2019 to May 2020, not as a graduate engineer, you are not registered as a graduate engineer, that work experience wouldn't count for your application as a professional IR, even though you have worked until May 2022, since 2019, because the record only says that you are a graduate engineer since 2020. So in my experience of applying for graduate engineer, I think one thing I want to share is to keep it in mind that you wanted to push the application through and then move on with your life instead of holding back and do it later or just procrastinating like what I do a lot. So what happens to my application is that I applied in 2019, December, as soon as I graduated and joined the company. However, my application, I have left out my university certificate that is not stamped by an IR, and I already have my transcript and IC stamped. So they replied me with an email that says that I need a university certificate stamped by IR for my application. And me being very occupied with work, and I feel a bit, I would say nervous or shy to approach my superior who is an IR to re-stamp my documents because I feel like I'm bugging her a lot through the process. So I hold it back until the year of early 2021, which is January 2021, to finally flip back up those documents to officially get myself registered as a graduate engineer. So what I do is that I finally printed out that document and reapproached her for stamping, and then I resubmitted my application, which takes another maybe 2 to 3 months for approval. And thank God that I've obtained my approval on May 2021. So my work from 2019 to 2021 work record wouldn't be valid to BEM at least, but it's something that I keep in my mind. Hence, I'm registered in May 2021. I would need to work at least 2 years, which is May 2023, to be qualified to register as an IR to move on to the next step. Lastly, I'd like to wish you all a smooth and successful journey to apply as a graduate engineer. So if you would like to hear more contents like this, please comment down below or subscribe to my channel and let me know any suggestions that you would like to know more in terms of engineering and the processes of certain other things that I could help you with. Alright, see you again next time.